on your mind, Mill?
Well, I live near the trailer park, Pat, and there's a big ruckus going on over there.
Well, that's just up the road from me, too. What's going on, do you know?
I don't know, but there's a bunch of police cars there, lots of sirens, a helicopter buzz, and I think I'm some gunshots.
Gunshots?
Yes, sir, like from a pistol. So can you find out what's going on? Because it's just next door, and they're popping off guns there.
They're still shooting?
No, it was maybe 10-15 minutes ago. It sounds serious, Pat. I'm telling you, it don't sound like no party.
The house station to call, Milt.
Okay.
You'll hear it here as soon as I hear from them.
Okay, thanks.
hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine. How to get to the... I wouldn't get a chance to ask anyone...
Come on in, Mr. Wake.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa.
I'm down here, right?
Cool your jets. We got him.
Shoot!
With you. There's a snare.
I had fallen off so many cliffs, it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine. There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd someone like me.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan. I'm so afraid. Keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. Something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
I'm here.
I'm so alone here. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
But that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there. That was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path. As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Steve had been a source of all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.
Take the facts of our existence for granted, unaware that they are merely a thin veneer of desperate self-delusion, covering a vast cosmos of madness and horror. All too often, the stars are right. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Family Occasion. Journalist Alvin Derlis' trip to study the local customs of an insular community in Night Springs has been less than successful.
Change your minds?
The ship.
Do your thing.
Perspective.
Of course.
Him.
I... What did you...
Please, Nixie. Shh, darling. Be calm.
Such quests always bear fruit. Nights.
never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine was far now. Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw. Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world, taken over by the Dark Presence, was trying to destroy me. It all fell, but it matched a textbook case of insanity.
This is Pat Maine, and you're listening to KBF FM. Folks, I want to apologize for kind of abandoning you to that looping music track last night, but I was detained. You see, I encountered a big-shot G-man with an itchy trigger finger who could use a lesson in manners and a boot in the ass, not necessarily in that order either. Now, folks, I know I'm not being very informative here, and I apologize for that. I really should just keep quiet, but I'm just so peeved right now, because some people just shouldn't be carrying badges. I'm just glad that our Sheriff Breaker was there to straighten things out. And if someone I met last night is listening, let me just say, I'm sorry if my mouth got you in trouble. I'm pretty sure you're not the bad guy here. Godspeed, son. I hope you know what you're doing. Now, on a lighter note, I'll be talking to Dr. Nelson all morning. But first, a little music. KBF FM. Hope you enjoyed that tune. Now, Doc, you were talking about life and finding that special someone, that soulmate.
Well, you were talking about that. I was saying I don't buy it.
Well, see, to me, that's strange, because I always pegged you as a hopeless romantic.
You got me there, Pat. But I think love's where you look for it. And you need to do a lot of looking, sure. But the idea that there's that one special person out there for you, and if you miss that chance, it's gone forever and you're forever incomplete. I mean, isn't that depressing? Or childish even? There's plenty of fish in the sea.
And apparently a fisherman has a fishing analogy, but...
Oh, no. What I am saying is that your potential for finding that connection is due to what's essentially a chance encounter. How is that harsh?
Yeah, well, I guess that's a nice thought, but let me say something personal here.
Okay.
Now, I don't disagree with you exactly, but I can't really fit that together with what I feel, what I felt for someone, because she was the one. She let her drift away. Maybe I didn't put in the work, I don't know, but, well, since then, and it was a long time ago, but since then, there hasn't been anyone, not like her. And I'm not saying I dwell on her or haven't moved on. I like my life. I'm not living in the past. But I do miss the way she completed me.
You can't argue with the heart, Pat.
I'm sorry, folks. I had kind of a scary experience last night. And let's just say it's shaken a few things.
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now.
Thank you.
I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back, or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
Wake!
Where the hell?
Peak is? It's a big mountain north of where. You follow the path from the mine, you can't miss it. There's a lookout point there. I'll be waiting.
I'm through being jerked around by you.
You wanna see your wife alive? Cause if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I wanna talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello! I'm gonna kill him!
I had to get to Mirror Peak. It was close. Maybe closer than ever before.
Thank you.
The only way to reach the hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.